Please check out our shirt on Teespring.
Hey folks, I'm talking about this TV series. It lasted for like first season. It had like 52 episodes. It was on NBC, and you can watch it on Netflix. It had a 97% on Rotten Tomatoes, and it is called The Good Place. Honestly, I just happened to be flipping on Netflix one time, and there it was, and I was checking it out. And really interesting outtake about somewhat kind of like heaven and hell, what happens to us in the afterlife. And also about becoming a better person, you know, in your lifetime, and try to help other people become better people in their lifetime.
Each episode is, 22 minutes long, and each season is only 12 episodes. Most shows are 24, but I think it's a good amount to just have 12 episodes per season. And the first season of it is more a comedy, and later on it becomes more kind of a little darker and a little more storytelling and more characters in it. It builds more about the good place and the bad place.
Focus on religion. Religion, pretty much you have to be perfect, go to heaven. And when you show up there, you know, they try to change things up there to say nobody's perfect. I mean, I guess there's some kind of point system for you to go to heaven or hell. And it's just ridiculous because nobody's perfect. We're going to make mistakes. As long as you learn from your mistakes and try to change later on, that's pretty much life should be. But you should not so be focused on death, you know, if I'm going to go to heaven or hell. But just focus being a good person, you know. It's kind of interesting, all the raunchy jokes it has. I was kind of amazed for NBC to have these people say certain things, and this is the first episode, but it's just, wow, that's what I would say about that, but it was just, that got my attention. What else can I hear to say next, later on? So this series, there's a good place and a bad place. The good place is, you know, everything you want. And there's a bad place where bad things happen, a lot of screaming, crying. So pretty much, it's more focused around the good place. It's pretty much somewhat heaven, feels like real. When you show up, you have this, not a robot or something else come, you just say Janet and she'll come down and grant your wish or anything you want. And also when you arrive there, they'll set you up with an afterlife soulmate.
The thing is that the good place is that you can't swear. Even if you try to swear, the words will come out differently. And they're kind of writing jokes, you know, instead of saying, you know, F word, it'll say pork. And like when you're a spell checker, when you try to text somebody or using bad words trying to text somebody, it'll like put the nearest word that's kind of similar to it. Kind of like that. That usually frustrates me more than anything else.
Crystal Bill's character plays Eleanor. Eleanor is really a lost soul. Bitter, hateful, just won't give a damn, you know, anything around her. And she kind of showed when she's leaving a store when she dies, it kind of shows, you know, what kind of person she was towards a lot of people, you know, kind of television, I don't give a crap, you're in my way. Also, it kind of shows her what kind of person she was. She worked at a total market selling these fake medication, you know, claiming, you know, the cure, all this stuff. And she didn't really care. That's what her point of view was. And then later on in the series, you could see her change and become, working to try to change people.
Also, the first season, when she first goes to the good place, Eleanor, she automatically realized that, you know, Michael made a mistake. She's not supposed to be here, she's supposed to be in the back place. So she kind of played this role that, you know, yeah, sure, I'm that person. And it's pretty interesting that Michael shows her her house. It's kind of weird. Everything uncomfortable to sit on. You got like tons of, all these clown paintings everywhere. So pretty much the first season is just her trying to keep people think that she's not. And because of that, the good place goes with kind of weird ripple, something unbalanced, something's going on, and someone should not be there is totally screwing the whole thing up. and weird things are happening because of her. And Michael's trying to figure out, you know, who's the pastor, what's going on here. He's like freaking out, doesn't know what's going on. And Jan doesn't know either.
The new place, the good place is the test. And later on, he learns to, like, there is hope for man. People can change. They just need, you know, the right influence to become a better person. And he learns that later on. Pretty much, you'll notice that Michael is not perfect. He'll make mistakes. And you got Darcy credit. I believe she would be a great comic actor in the future. You should see her on HBO. Barry. It is the last episode was a couple months ago. But her character is kind of interesting. I'm not really sure what she is. You know, the best way to describe her character, she is a kind of a genie. You know, but you just unlimited wishes. So you say Janet, she shows up. But each time she gets rebooted, she becomes, you know, more human feelings. And it's kind of interesting, you know, somewhat dull, bubble-like character. And later on, like around the first season, her character has feeling emotions. Kind of like it feels love and falls in love and gets married. So it's kind of interesting to see how much the character changes the last first season. There's a funny scene when Jenna explains where Columbus is, you know, all the horrible things he did, and that's why he's in a bad place, but she kind of explains why he's in a bad place, you know, true to history. Also, later on, wait for the bad Janet. I guess the bad place version of Janet. More hilarious, selfish, totally opposite, not caring, don't give a damn. I'm on my phone, I'm not gonna listen to you, whatever, go away. That kind of attitude was hella funny, by the way. So I was curious what these religious groups think of this, you know what I mean? Because how dare you question, you know, God in heaven. But it's, you know, it's like, if you don't like it, change the channel. If, you know, not everybody believes what you believe in. And for some reason, these fools don't know how to change the channel, you know? You know, there are people's thoughts, opinions, but that's how, you know, United States is. But it's a good series. I enjoy it. It's pretty funny, original. I mean, the characters, I mean, you kind of go, there's some flashbacks, kind of explain, you know, why they turned the way they became. And there's hope for, also, it's pretty positive. I think it was one had the best season, you know, endings ever, the most ever. And pretty much give you, like, hope for man. It's a good positive, you know what I mean? You know, bad become good in the end. That's pretty much best way to describe it. And sometimes you gotta learn, it's pretty much the thing is not be selfish, you know, try to help people, be good. And, you live one life, you know. You know, what people say about you, you know, generations from now. So, like and subscribe, let me know what you think. Maybe we'll do it better next time, and we'll see, alright? Thanks for watching.